There's no seam there. Flynn with the windshield wiper nearby. Krejci low to Backes to Spooner. He scores! There's your must goal, and it's back to one. Sweet feed from Backes.
A good response. This goes to that resiliency of the Bruins. They dug themselves a hole again tonight. The shorthanded goal by Byron. And then the pressure to score with the man advantage to get it back to the one-goal deficit. David Krejci, a lot of patience. The Bruins trying to get that set play, get into that triangle situation. But it takes skill to make a pass like that. It's got to get past the dive, and it's got to get tape to tape. Spooner makes a good move to make himself available.
Spooner dangling back of the net, skids it out to Krejci, over to Krug. Krug low for Spooner. Spooner holds, pass Bergeron to Krejci, flattens the puck. Krug the slap pass, Spooner scores! The Bruins patient on the power play, and the long drought is over.
What helped set up this goal, Jack, is the fact that Krug had taken a number of one-timers. You mentioned the four shots on the first 2 minutes of the man advantage. Well, two of them, or maybe even three of them, came from Torrey Krug in the middle of that offensive zone. And they're trying to set that triangle up again. They do it effectively. They work the puck the way they want to. Again, the decision-making and the execution. But the threat of that shot coming from the middle of the offensive zone is going to allow this passing lane to be set up perfectly for Ryan Spooner. And that one time was a perfectly delivered pass from Torrey Krug. A number of real good plays.
Well, if you give me that question in about six, 7 months, I'm going other.
Chara's drive scores! Zdeno Chara with a bullet from out top. The Bruins have been outworking Arizona for much of the game. Shoot the puck and good things happen. Bruins goal brought to you by Audi.
Well, Claude Julien was pretty animated during that commercial break, talking to his team, obviously not liking what he was watching here in the second period, and they respond coming right out of the commercial. David Krejci able to come out. Good battle in front, both Spooner and Backes with their checks. Getting to the top of the blue paint, Chara is able to get himself in a pretty good position.
Try Rangelon, he's exhausted right now. Try him.
Spooner tosses the backhand to Krug. Back to Spooner in front, he dinks, he scores! Spooner sticks a fork in him, and the Bruins win in sudden death, beating Montreal at Bell Center 2-1.
Hockey justice for the Bruins tonight, Jack. They had this game won, a late goal in regulation. They had it won in overtime, had the goal taken away. And I love the fact that the Bruins recognized that Radulov was beatable in this situation, and they attacked him. And it's huge that a guy like Ryan Spooner gets the game winner. I mean, this is a great play here. Protect the puck, throw it to space. And that's exactly where Krug is. You see two Canadians drift over. Now it's one-on-one, Spooner against Radulov. He just beat him back to the net. Great pass, great execution, and a nice finish. And it looks like Montreal is hanging around. Was there an offside on the long pass up?
With Krug saucers it to Krejci, who handles it nicely off the skate. The shot short side. Ward on the save. Krejci to Krug. The tip in front. Torrey Krug with a bullet from out high. And it either went off a Carolina defenseman or David Backes redirected it home.
Spooner in
or
the
maybe
neighborhood.
It's Spooner.
Yeah, Spooner in the neighborhood too. And, you know, you watch the players' reaction, whether it's Spooner or Backes, it really doesn't matter. What matters is the Bruins. We talked about playing with pace again tonight. They're doing it. The accuracy and some of the opportunities in the offensive zone haven't been there. Bergeron just had the best chance of the game until the Bruins take the lead. Backes is right at the top of the blue paint, but he's not going to be able to get this one-timer from Krug. He's going to go by his stick, but there's Spooner. Hanging around that far post, and it's going to hit him in the right skate and find the back of the net.
Back for Krejci! And it goes off the Leonard and wide of the goal. Kane was on Krejci all the way down. Spooner drives it and scores! The Bruins lead with less than 4 minutes to go! What an effort all the way back to the Boston zone. The little bunt from Vetrano that springs the rush, and Spooner is there to finish it.
When you're a left-hand shot playing the right wing in your own zone, and if you can position yourself with timing to make plays like this, it's such an advantage. Petrano, that little punchback diagonal. Krejci's in perfect position to pick it up with speed. Now you got a little something going through the neutral zone. And Krejci makes another big-time play deep in the zone. Corrals that puck, gets to space by creating separation. Even though he's moving away from the net, allows Spooner to get in position for the one-timer. And this is a real good shot.
Several seconds, not getting his sixth guy on the ice.
Spooner picks it off. He's got an empty net. He dinks. He scores! The Bruins take the saber and ram it through Buffalo's heart, coming from two down to beat the Sabres in their own barn.
And this looks good on Ryan Spooner. We talked a little bit about him because of the way Krejci and Backes played last game. He started a little slow, made some mistakes, but he got better the deeper they got into that game against the Blue Jackets. Now you lose Backes tonight, and you got to make some adjustments if you close Julian.
Carlo hammers it off the boards. The Bruins pour into the Toronto zone again. Dominic Moore against Nikita Zaitsev. Back to Chara. The wrist shot tip loose. Spooner scores! The Bruins have tied it 4-4.
What a strong shift by Dominic Moore as well. He makes a number of big plays. It started with a battle below the goal line. It allowed Spooner to make a play back to Char at the point. And then in the neutral zone, Carlo comes across, keeps the play alive, moving forward in center ice. But these moves right here by Dominic Moore. Spin off your man, draw another man to you. Now somebody's going to be open. When you draw multiple players to you defensively in the offensive zone, Char is going to get open at that left point, and then the Bruins. Pucks to the net, bodies to the net. That puck gets
back for the Bruins. Puts on the brakes, sends it back for McQuaid. In front, Hayes turns, and they score off the rebound. Ryan Spooner opens scoring, and it's 1-0 Boston.
Well, the Bruins do a nice job through the neutral zone. High percentage plays, meaning indirect off the boards, allow people to skate into it and carry that puck deep into the offensive zone. You don't want to pull up around the tops of the circles. You want to get in around the dot, and they're able to use the points. They will use the points if the play is there, it's the right play, but they're trying to make more plays below the circles. The Bruins get the benefit of the partially shot block and the missed net by Jimmy Hayes, but the two Massachusetts boys combined.
Now for Krug, he'll try the rush up, save maybe by Lettinen. Rebound sent back toward a pile of bodies in front. Now straight away pass, and a great stop there by Lettinen. David Pastrnak, who's going to have another chance high slot, goes for the pass in tight, picked up by Spooner, he scores!
Wow, what an assault.
Three great chances, two great saves, and then a goal.
All five guys are interchangeable. There's no real set plays except how they read off one another. And it's just good puck movement. Pastrnak, the confidence to be out high along the blue line. He teed one up early. Lettinen made a great save on there, but how active Torrey Krug is.
Stafford inside the line. Vetrano turns and fires, and Schneider was already square to the shot. Vetrano caves in Severson. The puck comes loose. Spooner scores! The triangle. Stafford posting up in the slot. Shovels over to Spooner. He makes no mistake, and Boston is up 3-2.
The trouble actually started for the Devils when they activated their D coming up the ice into the offensive zone. They couldn't get an offensive play going. And even though they get back, it's a nice play down low. Vetrano, good stick-to-itiveness. He actually wins a battle with two Devils below the goal line by pursuing the puck. Knocks down Severson, pulls that puck through the legs of Lappin, and they get into that perfect triangle, and high in the slot, Stafford. Stafford sells the shot. It's a subtle little drop of the shoulders. If he might take that drag snap,